Hey everyone, Jeff here. Just doing a quick tutorial today based on a question I got on Twitter, which had to do with how do you make a pattern follow a curved surface? And by pattern, this person was talking about a hatch pattern as well as rendered. So it got me thinking, and I remember a long time ago, probably 10 plus years ago on the blog, I had a post about this, but I literally couldn't even find it myself. So I figured I'd make a quick video to show you how to do this. I'm showing you with brick soldier coursing, but it applies to pretty much any pattern type. So yeah, let's jump in. So as you can see here, on the left-hand side, I have, this is just a floor with the brick material on it. I'll go into the material and show you what it looks like. It's a brick soldier coursing material. You can see it's just 4-inch parallel lines, and then the appearance is a the default brick soldier coursing appearance. And you'll notice if I use a floor or pretty much any object, right, you're gonna get this, okay? And the rendered appearance also looks like that. Now you look over here, you'll notice, well, this, the pattern is actually following the shape, which is pretty cool. So how did I make this? Well, it's actually pretty simple. So the way Revit works is if you're trying to force a UV, a pattern, a rendered texture, et cetera, to follow some kind of surface, you actually need to slope the surface slightly. So when you look at this, it looks like, hey, this looks pretty cool. If I look at it, it looks pretty generally the same shape as that. But if I dig into it, you'll notice this is actually a sweep. Okay, and then you're like, okay, well, it's just a sweep, fine, whatever. But then if I go to my profile, you're like, well, that's just a sweep with a square. But if you look really, really close, I zoom all the way in, the top of this sweep has a gentle slope to it. And what's even cooler is now that this pattern's following it, if I was to flip open to realistic, check that out. Hopefully you guys can see that. The brick texture is following the path. So notice on this guy how it's straight and flat. Here it's following the path. So it's actually forcing Revit to UV map the pathway. So there you have it. Super quick, super easy tip. But if you want to sort of force Revit, and it doesn't have to be a sweep, I think it works with some other shapes, but I've only ever had it done with a sweep. But if you give it that just a little bit of slope on the surface that you want to force the direction of a surface pattern, that'll sort of help. So thanks for the question. Whoever it was on Twitter, I'm sorry if I forgot your username. And I hope this helps other people. 10 plus years later, I guess this is the new blog post that I can find next time. So thanks for tuning in, guys, and see you soon.